Good morning, Dryden, Ontario. And thank you,
Walmart, for the perfect sleeping spot. So we drove to Dryden, Ontario last night. Got up this morning and grabbed some supplies and back on the road. I don't know what's going on. Way too much driving. So let's see what kind of surprises unfold today. Damn. Look at that thing. Lots of marsh, wooded areas, lots of lakes. The access to them is limited though. Yay. It didn't even have a name.
Well, bud, should we go exploring?
Guess there's a bit of a fire in here.
Like a Coke machine.
I thought about trying this door, but yeah, no, I'm gonna stop.
Says keep out. Yes. What's that? That's an old cooler. Pool table, picnic table, cassettes galore. Look, she's not playing.
This is definitely like a bar or party room. It even has a stage.
Looks like I found the laundry room. Huh.
It's eerie. There's so much stuff just left here on the side of the highway.
I guess it does have a name.
This was Stewart Lake Lodge.
I see dead people.
So again, let's say goodbye to Stewart Lake Lodge. And get on the road for sure this time. So, the further west I go, the better the weather is getting.
I'm happy about that.
Gorgeous though. So many lakes here. Kenora's just up the way. So I'm gonna grab some grits and fill up the fridge and see if I can find one of these beautiful lakes to camp at for a day or two, because I think we're into good weather. Yep, I had to stop. Not only for that, but for this. Now that's a bug. So we're in Kenora. I did my grocery shopping. And now we came down. I checked out Google and had to find out what Kenora had.
There's a dam downstream.
We have a couple of cool railway bridges. Here is what we've come to see. Something happening over there. I see a lot of people. I see a lot of people walking down there. I'm just contemplating if it's too far for me to walk, then I have to walk all the way back. My knees are killing me these days. Come here, Big Chew. So, Kenora has a population of around 15,000 people. It's quite a quaint little town. When you've gotten what you want. Oh, it's a farmer's market.
Tell me what to do.
So this is the old Trans-Canada Highway. I'm hoping there's a good spot down here. Would have been nice if it wasn't so marshy here. And marshy means mosquitoes. I turned up this road on my way back out. And found a whole crap load of cottages out here. So there's number 7. This is a Palmer and some chaise and 5 and 6. I don't remember where 6 is or 7 is. And that's the end of the line. I'd go in there, but it's all sand and probably get stuck, so we'll back out. And this is where I came in at. There's the old highway right there. And we're back on the Trans-Canada. So this is another part of the old highway that I turned down. And we're right on the border. This is my last night in Ontario. 100 meters down the road, it's Manitoba time. So I set up camp. I'm gonna try to do what I was doing the other day. Oh! It's a little windy here. Oh no! Oh no! Okay, all fixed. Yeah, so I'm just gonna set up this camp here and try to get some of this painting done on the van. Oops, I've been recording a lot of this. This spot is really windy. Did I say it was windy yet? Uh-oh, now I feel raindrops. Oh, crap. Because this is what I'm doing. And I was just gonna get ready to spray, move my van sideways. So the wind hits the far side. Little boy's having dinner. Mm-hmm. Dad is painting. Yeah. That's a rocker. I can see that. Well, that was way too much work and way too much wind. We're gonna call it a night. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Get your notification buttons. Please leave a comment. And we'll see you on the next video. Peace.